Wait, my husband was examined? I'm afraid all insurance companies need to pry a little bit. I congratulate you, the madame. You have a healthy husband, robust, full of energy.
Don't I know it?
Oh, I see. But that's very flattering.
Oh, yes, monsieur, but so exhausting.
Well, you can't get something for nothing.
And to think, that's what Madame Pluchot dreams about.
Who's Madame Pluchot?
My wife. She always makes me feel ashamed about it. She says she needs a man more like Madame's husband.
Well, with Madame's permission and Monsieur d'Estaing's consent, there may be a way to arrange that.
Oh, no, no, sirree!
That goes for me too, Doctor.
Oh, pardon me, Madame. It's this devil Etienne. It's a bad influence on me. I really must be going if I'm going to be back in 15 minutes. Forgive my nonsense.
Oh.
Madame, enchanté.
No offense taken, Doctor.
I hope not.
To get back to what we were talking about, Doctor, when I broke myself like this, my ovaries
just
start...
Just take a... Emma, calm down.
Oh, what a character. Seven past one. This is what Ramon calls eager to see me. Oh, well.
Oh, he made you burn me.
Monsieur?
Are you feeling me there with me if you did your end of the body back company?
I'm sorry, I can't understand a word you were saying.
I think, madame, if you may need to do the rest of the work.
Oh, no. I'm Francesa. I'm Francese.
Huh?
I'm French.
Ah, and me too.
If you're waiting for the butler, I'm just a visitor here.
I beg your pardon. I only asked because if you had to read it to the director of the Boston Art Company.
Yes, monsieur, yes.
I beg your pardon.
I've come to see if madame is in too bored.
Oh, my friend, tell me. A man just came in.
A man?
Yes, he spoke gibberish. I couldn't understand a word he said. Oh, something like that.
It's Monsieur Camille.
Oh, a foreigner, hmm?
Huh? Oh, not at all. He's Monsieur Chandevise's nephew. I can understand why Madame had the trouble. He has a problem with pronunciation, Madame. He can't pronounce his consonants.
You don't say.
Yes, Madame. It's very annoying if you're not used to it. I'm just starting to understand him a little.
Ah, he gave you lessons.
Not at all. But if you need to, you know, you begin to understand a little.
Oh, yes, yes.
So, Monsieur Chandevise hired him as a secretary since he couldn't get a job because of his, begging your pardon, damned way of talking.
Well, a man who can only offer you vowels.
Yes, there you have it. It's not enough. I know, of course, that when he writes, he has plenty of consonants. But one doesn't write all the time, obviously. Such a serious young man. So conscientious. But sad to say, no one's ever seen him with a woman.
Go on.
Not me, anyway.
Oh, well.
Ah, yes. Here's madame.
Oh, you, at last.
I made you wait.
You think so?
Oh, I have just been on a wild chase. Oh, Lucienne, something very serious has happened. My husband is cheating on me.
Huh? Victor Emmanuel.
Victor Emmanuel, exactly.
Oh, you say his name like you're throwing it on.
The best of me. I am going to trap him.
You're going to trap him? You mean you don't have any proof?
No, I doubt the swine. Oh, but I will get proof.
How?
I don't know. You're here. You'll find it for me.
I?
Yes, yes. Don't say no, Lucienne, no. You were my best friend at the convent. So we haven't seen each other in 2 years. The important things never change, huh? You used to be Lucienne Picard. Now you are Lucienne Comedy to stay to Stonewall. Your name got longer, but your heart is the same. I have the right to think of you as my friend forever.
Of course.
And I also have the right to ask you for help when I need it.
Thank you. Much obliged.
Yeah. Tell me, what should I do?
Do?
To trap my husband.
Do I have this faith? This is why you asked me to help.
Of course.
Oh, you're too kind. In the first place, what makes you think that Victor Emmanuel is trappable? He may be the world's
small bump in the road, a tiny problem or two, something. I had actually started to dream about taking a lover, just to create a little trouble for myself.
A lover? You?
Why not? You know, we all get these mushies. I had already fixed my eye on someone. Monsieur Romain Tournel, not to mention any names, we had dinner the night before last. You didn't notice him flirting with me? That surprises me. You, a woman. Yes.
Oh, he came even that close, my dear friend.
Oh, yes, well, it's just like he said. I'm your husband's best and most trusted friend. I'd be the perfect choice.
Oh, but I can't take a lover now. Not while my husband is deceiving me. Can I tell you something?
What?
You, my dear, deep down, are crazy about your husband.
Crazy? Me?
Yes, what do you think
that? Stop it. That really annoys me. You know, I do not mind deceiving him, but if he deceives me, no, that is crossing the line.
You have a charming moral code.
What? I'm wrong.
Yes, 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 but look, nothing you've said proves a thing.
What do you mean? It doesn't prove a thing. When a husband has been a raging river for years, and then suddenly, what? Nothing but a trickle.
Well, sure, you know, the Manazeres River often shrinks its banks, but it never runs off to another bed. And you've seen those gamblers at the casino who will thrill the crowd with their huge bets 1 minute and then bore them with penny ante one
minute. Yes, if only he played with his pennies! But no, nothing! He just folds his cards.
So what? That could just mean it's broke, not that he spent them somewhere
else. All right, sure. What about these?
What's that?
Suspenders!
Well, they look like suspenders.
Do you know whose suspenders they are?
Your husband's, I think.
Have you seen? You're not defending him now.
No, wait a moment. I only say that because I didn't think you'd be carrying around some other man's suspenders.
Fine, that's perfectly reasonable. But perhaps you can explain to me why he received these suspenders in this morning's mail.
In the mail?
Yes, in a package which I opened by mistake while I was inspecting his correspondence.
Why would you inspect his correspondence?
To see what was in it.
He really did. And that's what you call opening a package by mistake?
What else? By mistake means anything that isn't addressed to me.
Oh!
You see, you have to admit that if someone returned his suspenders by mail, that he must have forgotten them somewhere.
Oh, what else?
Do you know where this somewhere was?
Oh, you're scaring me.
The Pretty Pussy Inn.
What is that?
Well, with a name like that, it is not a family inn, that's for sure. Here's the package that came in. You can see the label. It's stamped right on there. Below it is my husband's name and address. Monsieur Chandebis, 95 Boulevard Malaisien.
Pretty Pussy Inn.
Oh, and it won't try too, dear. That's another name that says a lot. I'm telling you, it's all very sleazy. You see, there is no mistake. It is very clear what is going on. Yeah, until this arrived, I suspected something, seeing my husband was
saving his penny.
Yes. I said to myself, oh, all right. So what? But this put a flea in my ear.
Evidently.
And if you could only see this hotel, dear. It's so vulgar.
What do you mean, if I could see it? You know this place?
Naturally. I've been there.
Oh.
What do you expect? I wanted to get to the bottom of this mess. I said to myself, there is only one thing to do. Question the owner. Fine. If you think it's easy to question such a person, it is awful how immoral people stick together. I couldn't get anything out of it.
Well, that would be bad for business.
That is for sure. You know what he said to me. If I told you the names of my clients, you'd be the first one never to come here. Yes, me. Then he just crammed up a peep.
Why?
Oh, so it's clear we can't count on anyone but ourselves. If men stick together, we should too. Huh? You're trickier than I am. We know what's what. What should I do?
What the hell? You're just
lost. Come on, have a brainstorm.
Oh, yes. All right. How's this? Ask your husband to explain himself.
Oh. Oh, are you serious? You know very well he will just tell me some big fat lie. There is no bigger liar than a man. Unless it's a woman.
Yes, you're right. You're as bad as they are. The only two animals in creation who can lie. brilliant, but then again, your husband's a man. You take a sheet of writing paper, and you douse it with perfume, and you write your husband a letter, a real hot, steamy letter, as though it were from another woman, you follow me? And you finish it by asking for a rendezvous.
A rendezvous.
Which you go to, silly. If your husband shows up, you've got him.
Yes, yes, you're right. It's not brilliant. But it's usually the classic box that works the best. We're going to write to Victor Emmanuel right now.
Let's write to Victor Emmanuel.
Oh, but he'll recognize my handwriting.
Damn, if you've already written something to him, he's
listening. Listen, he doesn't know yours. You are going to write to him.
No, not me. It's so sneaky.
Exactly why I sent for you. Are you my best friend or not?
Stop it. You're leading me straight to hell.
Will you find my husband there?
Oh, lucky me. Right, give me a sheet of writing paper.
Here.
Not yours. It recognizes.
I'm stupid. You're right. Wait. I have something we can use. I bought this for my nieces for their day. Process server. I mean, seems I will write it a little more plainly, like, I'm the one who couldn't take her eyes off you the other evening at the Palais Royal.
Do you mind? I'll be all yours in a minute.
Raymond, I dreamt about you.
No, my friend. I cannot think about having an affair while my husband is having one.
Huh?
That kind of thing is all right if you've got nothing else on your mind.
But Raymond told me. And then you believe.
Yes? Oh, fine. Maybe I did. But that was before the suspenders. Now we have the suspenders. Goodbye!
She stirred up the suspenders? What does that mean? The suspenders.
You to them, my mother wishes to see.
What?
My mother wishes to see.
I don't understand what you're saying. You try to speak more clearly. My uncle wishes to see. Fine. Would you just say so?
Now, what do you think about that? I go to all the trouble of coming to get him, and he bawled me out.
Yes, monsieur, he's in.
Ah, good.
I'll let him know you're here.
Okay, very nice.
For now, my uncle be.
He made me repeat it. I wrote it down for him. He had the nerve to say to me, when you get gay through, fine.
Very delicate. Something very bizarre has happened to me.
Well, what is it?
Let's see. How can I explain? offense to you. You know that my wife is very attractive.
That's for sure.
Right. You also know that no one fools around less than yours truly.
Ah.
Wow. You sit up. Yes!
I don't know that, my friend.
Well, fine. I'm telling you. Now, you also might be surprised if I also tell you that Ramona is everything to me. Wife and lover. The last thing I have to tell you, if you don't mind my boasting, is that in husbanding her, I've always been A1.
Ah.
Why not? He said, ah. Yes!
I don't know that, my friend.
Fine, I'm telling you, I want to mend something.
Fine, why all this preamble?
Oh, well, fine, here we go. Have you seen a play of the novelty called Nothing to Declare? I asked you if you've seen the play Nothing to Declare.
My God.
Well, either you've seen it or you haven't seen it.
I'll tell you. Yes and no. You see, I wasn't alone in my box, so...
Oh, right. Right, there were gaps.
Voila!
Doesn't matter. You saw enough to catch the drift. A train compartment. A nice young man is on his honeymoon with his new wife. He's about to teach her the first principles of wedded bliss when, all of a sudden, in the middle of the lesson, the customs man bursts in and bellows, "Anything to declare," and cuts the lesson short!
Yes, I remember! Vaguely?
Well, my old friend, it's clear the customs man didn't cut your lesson short.
No, he didn't.
Anyways, this poor young man, from that moment on, he's obsessed. Each time he has even the slightest impulse to climb on board and continue the lesson with his wife, he sees the customs man and hears, "Anything to declare?" Yes, nothing!
How annoying.
Yes. Well, my dear friend, that's exactly what's happened with me and my wife.
Well, you... Oh.
Exactly. One fine day, or rather one nasty night, about a month ago, I was very amorous, as usual. I made a suggestion to Madame Chandelier. She welcomed the suggestion when, all of a sudden, I don't know what happened, but...
The costumes man came in.
Yes! Oh! It's like an uneasiness, a disorder. I feel myself becoming a boy. A boy. A very little boy.
Hello, how are you?
Can't complain. Did you
You come to see my wife?
Actually, I'm coming back. I had some errands to run while I saw her earlier, and Monsieur as well.
Hello again. Oh, well, then I see no need to introduce you. Notice any jumpiness?
You mean the doctor?
No, my wife. I don't know what happened this morning. You couldn't touch her with a 10-foot pole.
I didn't notice.
Well, then, so much the better.
Ah, you're here.
Hello again.
Well,
it's done. He's right behind me.
Oh, good.
Monsieur.
Hello?
Voila.
A messenger brought this personal letter for you, monsieur.
For me? Wait, may I?
Yeah.
Ooh, my little stars.
What?
Nothing.
Anything wrong?
It's just business.
Oh, come on. I think that clears things up.
Oh, no, no, my dear friend. Women are a constant mystery. You'll never guess what just happened to me.
What?
Oh, did you forget about me? Oh, good. Come in. You're just in time.
What's going on?
Hello, doctor.
Hello, Janelle.
Well, boys, listen to this. I'm going to have an affair.
You?
Can you beat that? Wait, I'm not making it up. I'm the one who couldn't take her eyes off you the other evening at the Palais Royal.
You!
Me! Exactly! She couldn't take her eyes off me!
Great! Put her there!
And you?
You were in a box with another woman and a man.
And a man. There you are. It was you. And a man. That is, a nobody, a blank, a zero!
Is that right?
It's my turn. Someone next to me told me your name, and that's how I know who you are.
Oh, that's gotta be a joke.
Since then, I have dreamed only of you.
No!
Oh, yes, she only dreams of me.
Is that right?
Yes, that's right.
God, that's strange. Well, don't you think so?
Well, one can dream of all kinds of things.
Evidently. Depends on what you ate before bed.
What do you mean?
No, I'm joking.
I'm afraid to do something foolish. Do you want to do it with me? Poor little sweetheart. She's really fallen hard, haven't she?
Why?
Because of what I just read to you.
Ah.
I will be waiting for you today at 5 o'clock at the Pretty Pussy Inn.
The Pretty Pussy Inn?
Yes, well, come see.
Oh, take it from one who knows. It is a real experience.
Why, is this hotel?
Oh, it's a dream, monsieur. Oh. I saw all my hosts there.
Well, you know, that's what I get for living a pure life. I've never even heard of the place.
I'm sure, Monsieur Tonelli.
No. I know the name.
That's all. Oh, my
what?
Friend!
What?
She wept!
No!
Oh, yes! She wept! Listen, why, when I write to you, am I unable to hold back the tears? Oh, please, let them be tears of joy and not tears of despair. Oh, you can't deny it. A real cloudburst!
Oh, boys.
What?
Oh, boys, her tears pack a wallop. How does she do that?
Tears have their secrets.
Ooh!
More respect there, mistress.
Sure. Janelle, I can make a conquest too. You see, while we were at the Palais Royal, totally unaware, a woman was devouring me with her eyes.
Voila!
Did you notice a woman staring at me?
No. That is, there was a moment. Well, I thought she was looking at me.
Well, of course you... Oh, I'm such an idiot. Obviously.
What?
I'm not the apple of her eye, you are.
Me?
What else? We're in my box and my name is mentioned. She couldn't take her eyes off you. She mistook you for me.
You think so?
You bet.
Maybe. Yes!
I mean, really, could I inspire a love affair in me? As for you, it's only natural. It's your purpose in life. It's his purpose in life. Women's heads. You're handsome.
Go on. Go on.
The mystery's solved.
You can't be too sure about it.
No. I have a little charm, but that's all.
You hear that? A little charm? Ugh. Romeo, I don't even want to talk about it. Come on, tell us the truth. Women have killed themselves over you, yes or no?
Oh. One.
Aha!
She didn't really die. She's fine now. It was debatable. She poisoned herself eating clams.
Clams?
Yes. As I was leaving her, she told everyone she was heartbroken, but everyone knows that when you commit suicide, you don't use clams. It's too risky.
Come on, it's as plain as day. The letter was addressed to me, but it was meant for you.
What do you think?
I don't care.
Of course. Since it was meant for you, you shall go.
No.
Besides which, I'm not really like rolling a bag before American directors.
No, listen! No, really.
Look at you, you're dying to go.
You think so?
Look, your nostrils are flaring.
My nostrils? They're flaring? All right, then, I accept.
Romeo, go on.
This works out well for me. I was working on setting up a little adventure of my own, but it's been postponed.
Really? With whom?
Oh, with, I can't tell you.
Tell me.
Oh, Romeo, go on.
Your mystery woman will tide me over.
Be my guest.
You're too kind. Go on, give me the letter.
No. Anyways, why should I? You don't need it. All you have to do is go to the hotel at 5 o'clock and ask for the room in my name. You know, I don't often get letters like this one. I like my grandchildren, if I ever have any, to find it among my papers. Then they can say, Grandpa must have been really handsome to have signed such a passionate woman. At least I can be handsome in posterity. Come on, doctor, time for my checkup.
Ah, good, and the signatures.
2 minutes on all yours. Wait, Pinoch, if you go in here, we won't be screwed.
You're the boss!
2 minutes? 2 minutes! Then after that, something else. I've gotta go to the... pretty pussy. Who is this woman who's so... inflamed with me?
Where's my husband?
He's in there at the doctor. I'll call him.
Oh, no. Don't trouble yourself. If you see him soon, tell him I've gone out with Madame de Estampa. Not to worry if I'm late coming back since I may dine out with a friend.
Oh, well, I believe he'll be out late also.
What? Why do you say that?
Huh? Well, I think he told me he's giving a banquet this evening for his American director.
He told you that? Well, I am glad to hear it because it is a lie. The banquet isn't until tomorrow night. I have read the invitation, so there!
Well, then he's got the day wrong. I should tell him.
No. He did not get the day wrong. Don't waste your breath. This is all totally deliberate. It's an alibi so he can come back saying he confused the dates. I know perfectly well what's going on.
I assure you, he was totally sincere. Look, he has no reason to lie to me.
But he does have a reason to lie to me.
But not at all. You're making me say things I don't mean to say.
I see. Oh, go on. I know your little game. You know I won't have an affair with you while Victor Emmanuel is deceiving me, so you're trying to convince me he's the world's most faithful husband.
But I swear to you, I'm telling the truth.
Yes. Well, it is too bad. Goodbye.
Raymond! Oh, Raymond!
Making the difference. It's not for me, the insurance. It's for my wife.
Well, you didn't tell me that.
I tell you,
I want the letters. You must be for who?
Oh, it's a small mistake. Easily fixed. Madame May has just needs to come into the office tomorrow.
And yeah. And you are made for a piece like me.
What else?
No, I am not permitting this. I am not permitting this. I am not permitting this.
You must be reasonable. It's a rule.
The rules? You don't make the rules. I have peace for her.
No. That's not possible.
What? She will not be a judge. And so spending.
Really? You can't be that jealous.
She stood up, but she know what would happen. She would be afraid. Huh? You see this pistol?
No, play things like that.
It's so dangerous. It's only little pistola. See, Sherlock, gosh, my wife was another Moussel. Very Moussel. He will get the bullet in the back. Bam! And that will go out the back.
Out his back?
No, her back.
Oh, I see, because they hit me.
Get away! Do you understand this? I'm telling this to her the night of our wedding.
A charming announcement.
Let's get going, old friend.
In a second.
I've got to be you know where at 5 o'clock.
Right away, get the papers ready, and I'll be all yours in a second.
Where is his name?
Mr. Tunnell.
Tunnell?
Yes, a friend of mine, and also a member of the company.
Yeah.
A charming fellow. Monsieur Tunnell, may I? He's gone. He has only one tragic flaw. He's a real skirt chaser. Just now, he's rushing to get out of here because he has a woman waiting for him.
Oh, yes, el toro, huh? Bravo!
Well, I say she's waiting for him, but she's really waiting for me.
For you.
Oh, yes, I'm giving her to Tunnell. But it's to me whom she wrote this beautiful letter boiling over with love.
It's truly. And who is this love-sick guy?
I don't know. It's not signed.
Someone in Nottingham, perhaps.
I'm beginning to think so. Some for my baby.
What may you think this?
Well, first off, the style and tone. Come on. Floozies are less sentimental and more straightforward.
If you see him, can you just...
I can't wait any longer. And neither can she.
Da!
Da!
Huh?
Da!
What I meant!
Oh, no, what?
Nothing!
No! No!
Potentially fatal consequences of his actions, but it fell upon deaf ears.